Hey, fellas. I have a meeting with Mrs. Braithwaite. My associates are already here.
All right, that's enough. Move along now.
Please come in, sir. This way, sir. A gentleman to see you, ma'am.
So, your friend, the other liquor vendor. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Arthur, welcome. We're just playing cribbage. Arthur Morgan, Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he is big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big. But his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think, well, he's not quite that dumb.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we can take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper, bonds, metal.
She ain't gonna pay you in a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle
on earth?
Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
Hop on. I'll fill you in on the way.
No, I'm driving.
Fine. Ready? Let's get out of here.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of hers. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his arse. A smug fucker.
Okay. So what's she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep. Using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting, she did. All I'm thinking is how about I try fitting my boot up your hook nose, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right fella for tea at the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. There really better be some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Easy, easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still, tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way. They were saying old man Gray's double security after that business at the saloon.
So, we're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry, I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. Especially now they're taking on all that extra muscle. We're making a delivery, that's all. Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then. Yeah.
Up a second. Are you not worried about them Grays English?
Excuse me?
You not worried about them greys?
In what sense?
Well, they knows you.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
You know what? Here, I'll go hide and back. If you can act naturally and stop us from getting into a fight before we're ready.
I will try.
Yes. Try and do an impression of a human being.
I'm not going to go that far.
We're here. Stay out of sight. I'll do the talking.
Hold him right there.
What you want, boy?
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal in Ireland.
You don't say?
Yeah. They said you'd understand some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Sort of business. Before the officials got there, they said.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink. Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. Fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right? Then you and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here. Straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah, and they said they was looking for more drivers in town. I jumped at the chance. I ain't never been a feller to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. Bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half of it. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horses like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Huh. Real fancy places they was, Hamish. Real fancy, because if some folks got all the money, they can build quite the fanciest places imaginable, eh? Mm. Well, the average man sups on shite, yeah? Okay, you can hold up in here till it gets dark.
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. There's plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves. We coat everything in moonshine, and then we light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained. And that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
They should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm rebel stock, boy. I was barn burning down manor houses.
We'll burn quietly.
someone coming on the left.
Ha.
Oh, hey. Well, I thought the wagon already arrived.
This one didn't.
Strange. So, what you got there?
Tools, payroll.
Okay. Drop it by the supply shed at the back of the fields.
Sure. See you later.
You hear that? Payroll.
Yeah. Let's get this job done first, okay?
I'll take care of this fella. Come on. You douse the fields. I'll meet you at the barn.
Try to stay out of trouble. That's good for here. Should be enough for here. Do it.
We give this a quick dousing as well.
Think she'll go, Arthur. Light her up.
You got a fireball, right? Yeah. Now let's burn those bloody fields to the ground.
I got the red head.
We'll deal with these fellas. You keep burning.
Here's somebody shoot him already.
Not right now. We got company. Look out.
Let's go!
This is a goddamn mess.
You wait! Look out! There's more of them!
There goes our ride out of here.
The wagon we saw come in earlier. We can nick the horses from that.
All right, where is it?
This way! Shit!
More of the bastards!
Stay with me!
More guards coming in!
They didn't tell me nothing!
You're done! I want them dead! Now!
Come on! See? There it is! Maybe they haven't unloaded our cash yet!
Hosea better get us paid real well for this!
Bloody right!
All right, come on, we'll take those horses.
We'll see if the payroll is actually in there.
Hurry up.
Oh boy, we did good, Morgan. We did good.
Great, but let's go.
Looky here, you get them horses, Free Marker. Come on.
Suit yourself! I ain't waiting around to get shot!
Jesus, that turned into a right party.
You call that a party?
That Braithwaite had got a money's worth, Arlie.
Let's just get out of here first.
I think we lost them.
That we did.
Quite a night.
Sure.
Interesting little fight Dutch has put us into the middle of here.
I hope him and Jose are right and that there's some money at the end of it.
Well, what now?
Head on back to camp.
You coming?
Sure.
Here we are. Home, sweet home.
You let Hosea know how we got on.
Will do. Hey, you got any tobacco? I'm busting for the smoke.
Can I help you?
Well, looks like you boys had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables, I think.
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend.
You don't know me. You turn up in town, you're helping everybody. And there's troubles everywhere. Bandits attack my fields. Men getting killed. Just who are you?
That awful business was nothing to do with us. I like smoking tobacco, not recklessly burning it. Like I said, had a run of bad luck in the West. Lost money in some failed railway speculation. We heard good men can do well in this country.
Sure, and bad men. We haven't recovered as well as I'd hoped from the war. My family try. My sons are good boys, but it's been hard. Like I said, some people in the area will hold us all back forever. We need stability.
I'm sure.
We're an old Scottish family. We work. My daddy taught that to me, and I taught my son. Work hard, be fair.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
That hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels. Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000 for horses.
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
The stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbred.
Yeah.
Behind you.
On you go.
Crazy old fool.
If he only knew we just torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property? Sean was like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But if we get even a third of that, it'll be worth it.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
Good.
Careful. guard.
I'll speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
Our partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay then, but head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
And easy. No need to rush. Don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. All right. I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down. Play cool. Head around the front, hitch up there. All right, let's hitch up here. You can rest now, boy. Let me do the talking.
You boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. That's what you're interested in. What is your boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. This here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing.
I'll grab the white one in the middle, you get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Whoa there.
Easy.
Now.
Easy. It's okay.
Marston, you're gonna tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're gonna lead the stallions. Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, we regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Go, get out of here. I got the back.
What the hell are you doing? Stop! Stop! We're being robbed! I said stop these men! Stop! Look out ahead! They're coming out of the fields!
We lost him.
so.
All right, let's get these horses to Clemens Cove quick before we run into any more trouble.
Whoa, you okay there, boy?
Shit, one of the stallions is loose. Keep going, I'll get him. Come here. Hey, hey. Hey, now.
Clemens Cove's just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cuban. Here, you ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours. But I like you, and I can give you $650 for them.
I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys. But I ain't got more than $700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on, yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Believed a yarn spun us by one of that Gray family and imagined we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.
Arthur.
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
I'm not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
So, I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay, I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
You okay?
Hiya.
Yeah.
So, where are we going?
Dutch wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us. Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that. Soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it.
So, spirits seem good. In the new camp, I mean.
We got some space between us and that mess now. Ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us. We didn't even get away with the money.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Of course. Trelawney. I've only met him a couple times, but he's... Why are we stopped? He's a strange one.
Fear not. He's just a cockroach in fancy breeches. But he gets into nooks and crannies the rest of us can't. We just need to find him before he scurries off again. I think it's just up here.
Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house. There's some blood here. That ain't good.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd
Look,
say. I guess
tracks.
Maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet. We should get going.
They went down the path here. How's your tracking these? Hey, get back on your horse.
Come on, we need to go.
Hey. You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean, after our fight, I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find them.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that. Hey, look. Let's go see what those fellas have to say. Whoa! Yeah! Excuse me.
Yeah.
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
Yeah. All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here.
Come here.
It's Trelawney.
I don't know anything.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay, okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
Let me see you again, you hear me?
You got lucky there, my friend.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite's place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, though.
You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent. Keeping fish on the line. That must be it. Oh.
Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen. Is that the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive.
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Look, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
Don't deal with them, my brothers.
Who knows what he told them? Let's get after those sons of bitches. We got one more, Charles.
Look at the birds. Go that way.
Something on the ground over here.
He's dumped his gear. Look around. He can't have gone far. You see anything?
He's mine! Let me take him. Let me get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet. Come on.
You should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you. Gunshots are coming from that bar! Come on!
You gotta help out here!
Give him some help!
He's backing off inside! Get after him! There he is! Take him out! Good. He should be the last of them.
All right, let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy. Does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery feller.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
I hope you're right.
Mr. Trelawney, where are you?
Over here, dear boy.
Well, he's still here, at least. Put your feet up, why don't you?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
There always seems to be more, more and more civilization. I want to get back in the open country of the West, or what's left of it, but well, even that ain't the way I remember it.
Are you busy, Arthur?
Why?
Well, I know you think I'm just some effete buffoon.
What?
A man of words and not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I've found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
No, never. Well, who would have even thought? Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed man attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing?
Sometimes.
I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
Well, I could require a whole lot.
How's it going? It's not me best day. Sorry to hear that.
So where do we find this friend of yours?
Rhodes!
Because what can possibly go wrong there?
Well, lead the way and we'll find out.
You sure seem to have got about around here.
You know me. I like to make friends in low places.
How the hell you end up down here anyway?
I could ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats?
Among other things. I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
I've done my part. Each to their strength, dear boy. Yourselves with those two families. Here we are. We can hitch up outside. I'll make the introductions, Arthur.
I ain't going around you.
Many more folks want this job if you don't.
Come on. Hang back a bit and let me do the talking. We don't want to scare him off.
They've run out of effect, Scotch. Again.
Just how it is.
Well, there it is.
Hello, Alden.
Hello, Josiah. How have you been?
Dandy. And you, friend?
Like I said, times are tough. My missus is a bad woman.
terrible woman.
They often are. But how's work, Alden?
Terrible. Wages got cut again. They reckon they just invented a new horse's carriage will be the end of us.
They've been saying that nonsense since they invented the wheel. The wickedness of bosses.
I know. My comrades here and I are greatly discouraged from the adequate fulfillment of our duty.
A discouraged man is no man at all, Alden. No man at all. My friend Arthur here has a present for you.
Here.
Ain't you kind, sir?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay, well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah. It'll be coming south down the river road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there, a feller called Hector. He's also one of the, what did you call us again?
Discouraged men, Alden.
That's it, discouraged men. I like that.
Well, goodbye, Alden, or should I say, adieu.
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
I thought you might like to see that pantomime.
River Road through Siltwater Strand, he said.
Okay. I think I know a good spot to wait. Follow me. Okay, let's go. This way. Yeah! What did I tell you? Simple as can be. Seems a lot of the station workers are in on it these days. Earning a pittance, the unions are whipping them up, so they want something on the side. Like he said, there, Strawberry. Could create a lot of opportunities for a man in your line of work.
I ain't sure about going back to Strawberry after all that market business.
Didn't sound like you left anyone alive to recognize you, so I wouldn't worry too much, dear boy. All this trouble. You gentlemen are becoming quite the celebrities, aren't you? Soon you'll be on the front of a dime novel. And dead, of course.
We're hoping to be long gone before that. Dutch has a plan.
Here we are. This is the spot. Okay, this should do.
Sure. Here.
I'm hoping we won't need those.
Better safe than sorry. So what were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strong box, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strong box, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strong box without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary. But you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is Damson.
Oh, very good, Alden, very good.
Of course, if anything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do. Hold tight.
They'll be here soon.
There it is. Right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you. Please leave that gun in its holster for once. I'll ride ahead and get the coach to stop. You hang back. Don't let them spot you or you'll scupper the whole thing.
Miss Damson, you owe it to West Elizabeth.
Can we go, please? I got a train to catch.
Oh, won't you be quiet, you horrible little man?
One more time, from the top.
Il fugge cogitor.
Madam, I've heard enough. Might I have your card? The event is on the 23rd of this month. I can't say enough. But Mrs. Damson, my name. So sorry, gentlemen, for the interruption. Farewell. Nicely done, Arthur. A little finesse for once.
Well done, sir. Well done.
It was easy. You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy. Teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, it's only good. Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.
Okay.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called...
Hey, Molly, where's Dutch?
Well, however it goes.
I'm not sure all that line of thought serves you and me very well.
That's because, Cowpoke, you are a man of profoundly limited intelligence.
No doubt.
Well, you and the old man and Dutch have been running around, digging us ever deeper into shit. Old Mr. Pearson might have gone and lightened the load a little. Pearson! Ain't you curious?
I guess.
Gentlemen.
Dutch, you tell him, fat man.
It's peace, Dutch. The O'Driscolls. I mean, I think there's a way.
What on earth are you talking about?
Get the words out properly, fat man.
I met a couple of the O'Driscoll boys on the road in the town, and things were about to get ugly. But you know how I am in a fight, huh? Like a corner tiger. Anyway... Somehow it didn't, but we got to talking, and they suggested a parlay to end things like gentlemen.
Gentlemen. Combe O'Driscoll. Have you lost your minds?
You're always telling us, Dutch, do what has to be done, but don't fight wars ain't worth fighting.
They want a parley? It's a trap.
Well, of course, it's probably a trap, but what do we got to lose finding out?
Get shot.
We ain't getting shot because you'll be protecting us. It's a trap. You shoot the lot of them. If it ain't a trap, that's slim chance.
I don't see the point in any of this.
It's a chance you've gotta take.
I killed Combe's brother a long time ago. Then he killed... a woman I love dear.
As you say, it's a long time ago, Dutch.
Let's go. You and me, with Arthur protecting us, no one else.
What about me?
This ain't the time for tigers, my friend.
Fine.
Mount up then, Morgan. Let's go then.
Yeah.
Giddy up. Whoa there.
You know, I've been fighting Combe for so long now, I can barely remember a time when it was different.
And you're still fighting him now. Make no mistake of that.
Here he goes, Doubting Thomas. Is there any plan you ain't sour on?
Maybe you're right. Just nervous. Let's not waste any more lives needlessly.
I ain't costing lives here. I'm saving them. What did you say? We had Pinkertons coming after us.
Because of Blackwater.
And Leviticus Cornwall and his private army. Then who knows when this local hillbilly thing will come to a head, hmm? Can we really afford to be fighting on all these fronts? And O'Driscoll.
There is wisdom in that.
I hope so, gentlemen, but like I said, I'm nervous.
Look, you ain't even going to be the one in danger. We'll get on over there, find a nice perch for you to settle into. You got that rifle, don't you?
Yeah.
Then me and Dutch walk right in to the lion's den. With you to cover us, hmm?
Okay. Just keep calm, unless I give you a reason not to.
Oh, we'll be fine. We got you.
I will do my best.
Oh, my dear and trusted friend, with you watching over me, I would walk into hell itself.
As would I. Hey, up there. Men on the ridge.
O'Driscoll's, from the look of them.
I don't like having eyes on us.
We're close. You'll be the eyes soon enough. Maybe he's right, Dutch. Maybe I have pushed too hard. Got us into situations that could have been safer. I see all those mouths we gotta feed, and I dream too big. Caring too much. That's my problem.
Caring too much? There's no such thing.
This is horse shit from both of you.
It might be. Micah might be full of shit. Combe O'Driscoll might be full of shit. The promise of this great nation, men created equal, liberty and justice for all. That might be nonsense, too, but it's worth trying for. It is worth believing in. Can't you see that, friend?
I don't know.
Try. All I ask is you try.
All right, cowpoke. You're gonna peel off up ahead. We'll be meeting down on the plain. Find a spot just above us where you can keep an eye on things.
All right. However this shakes out, let's aim to meet back at the fork in the road afterwards.
We'll be there, partner.
Yep. Done real well, boy. Yeah.
Hello, Dutch. It's been a while.
Sure.
So, how's your gang doing? They still believing in you? Better world. Pure world. How's that coming along?
Just fine.
How's that score you stole off us?
Which one?
Oh, I like that. It's like I said, this is a charismatic leader. A lot of heat on us this time. Both of us. Whole heap of trouble. They offered me a price, Dutch, to bring you in.
Why didn't you take it?
Well, still might.
I am sorry about your brother.
Yeah, well, I never liked him much.
I liked Annabelle.
You always loved the ladies, Dutch Vanderlyn. I like that about you.
What are we doing here? Go home. Is this thing over?
Got a sense.
Handing him over to the law, it's, I don't know. Strange times.
They killed Seamus. Fuck the whole lot of them. With this fella Colum's right, we can draw them all back.
True. Where'd Colum and Patrick head off to?
In a town, I think, to speak to the law.
That has to be crap. It ain't worth the risk.
Colum's got a sense about Vanderlyn. He can play him. Once he realizes we got his man here, they'll all come right in.
He's escaping! Shoot him!
Did I kill you?
Oh, not yet.
No, of course not. Not yet.
But I will.
Finally, put his weapons over there.
Morgan, it's good to see you.
Hello, Cole.
How's the wound?
I hardly feel it.
You will. Septic, ain't nice. Now, tell me, fine gun like you, why are you still running around with old Dutch? Could come ride with me and make real money.
It ain't about the money, Colm.
No, no. It's Dutch's famous car. You killed a whole bunch of my boys. Six-point cabin.
I ain't got no clue what you're talking about.
Oh, you lie, my friend. And I thought Dutch preached truth.
Let me go, Colm, and end all this crap between you two. We all got real problems now.
The way I see it. They get him. They forget about me.
They ain't the forgetting sort. If I were you, I'd run as soon as I had the money.
Oh, I know you would. Let's see. We lure an angry Dutch in to rescue you. Grab all of you and hand you in. Then disappear.
So you only met with him to grab me?
Of course.
be so mad, he gonna come raging over here. And a whole lot of you. And the law will be waiting for him. Arthur. Arthur. I missed you.
I don't want to go to Mexico. I want to go home. Home! Hold on, I'll be back in a minute. What the hell?
Who's talking now, huh?
What's he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. He better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law comes for that side of beef.
Forster.
I told you it was a subtouch. Oh, my boy, my dear boy, what? They got me. I got away.
Yeah, you did.
Miss Grimshaw, I need help. Reverend Swanson.
He's gonna set the law on us.
Oh, of course he was.
I'm sorry, Arthur.
It is a bit late for apologies. Swanson!
Mr. Morgan. Mr. Morgan, you're safe now.
Oh, let's get him to bed.
You are safe now, Arthur.
Okay. I got you.
You're safe now.
That's pretty, it does. That's real pretty.
Miss Grimshaw, will you sit with him a while?
Of course. You'll be okay, Mr. Morgan. You're home.
I thought I'd be burying you, Mr. Morgan.
Well, not quite yet, River.
Good. How you feeling?
About the same as you.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, take care of yourself.
You too.
Been waiting for you, Arthur.
Well, I'm sorry to have kept you.
Come on, let's get going.
What's the plan?
We're meeting a couple of the Greys over at the saloon. They spoke to Bill about a job needing security.
After the farce of stealing the horses for them, why are we doing this?
Because we need to stay in with them, and they're paying.
So what kind of security they want?
We're about to find out. Now come on.
This seemed legit to you, Bill.
Sure. Dutch said we was to keep on dealing with him until we find this gold.
Can we trust them?
Can we trust anyone?
Yeah.
Let's just see what they say.
They said there was some big misunderstanding about them horses.
And what about boarding their fields?
They don't know we had anything to do with that.
Oh, that's so.
Yeah. They think it was the Braithwaites. Listen, I know these Grey boys a bit now. This is on the level.
We're stuck in the middle of some ancient feud, but instead of playing both sides, we're being used by both of them.
They were saying the Catherine Braithwaite.
Hey, hold up. This don't feel right.
Now it don't feel right? I could have told you. Shit!
What the hell? Get down!
Thank you.
the front! None of these bastards gonna walk out of here! Shit!
Getting sloppy, Morgan.
Do you see that window and Sean's skull? Don't talk to me about sloppy.
Better in here, not there. Sons of bitches sooner or later. Just turned out to be sooner. See that? Those cowards are running away.
Looks like most of them.
Not all of them.
Sheriff Gray. And what about Bill? Where the hell's he?
We'll find him later. Come on. Sheriff Gray! You need to get a hold on this town. It's going to hell.
Who do you think you are? Bunch of two-bit thugs from God knows where? You're so dumb to think we don't know what you've been doing.
Come out, Sheriff. It's over.
We put down far worse than you, 100 times over. This is the Gray's town. Always has been, always will be.
Only Gray's I see left around here is you.
You want us to come out? We'll come out!
Shit.
Aw, Bill.
Guns on the ground, now! Both of you, don't do it!
You know we can't do that. You put the gun down, Sheriff!
I'll blow his brains out!
You want to join your little friend there, do you?
Either way, you're a dead man. Morgan?
A good kid.
Well, how the hell was I to know?
Let me see. They set us up once before. They didn't like us. We destroyed their farm. Should I go on?
Go easy on him, Morgan. He was out trying to find a lead. Same as you. Same as Hosea. All you do is complain when things don't work out. Except when it's your goddamn fault.
You don't know what you're talking about. You don't give a damn about nobody but yourself.
Oh, you act so high and mighty, but you're no better than the rest of us. I've ridden with you boys close on, what, 6 months now? And all you ever done was complain. You can fight, but you can't think.
You can't do either.
Okay, cowpoke.
Bill, take the boy's body. Bury him proper someplace quiet. Micah, best you and I don't speak for a moment.
I'm just so frightened by you.
Get out of my sight, pair of fools. He was like an annoying little brother to me. What fun we had riding together. What a goddamn mess we are making of things. You seen that boy, Jack?
No.
Where's my goddamn son? Where is he? Where's my son? They took him, didn't they? They took my son.
Who took him?
We think the Braithwaite woman took him.
Oh.
But Kieran saw a couple of fellows sound like Braithwaite boys.
Where's my son? If anything, where is my son, Dutch Vanderlyn?
We will find him. We will bring him back to you. And we will kill any fool that had the temerity to touch one hair on that boy's head. Abigail, you have my word.
Just get me back, my son.
I will get that boy back, so help me God. Right now.
Dutch, we just heard about Jack. You need some extra guns?
Yeah, why not? Micah, Kieran, anyone strange turns up, you kill them. Rest of you, let's ride. Okay, let's go get that boy back.
They must have figured out what we was up to, Dutch.
Yeah, we just got shot to hell by the Grays in town.
I know. I heard about Sean, too. I don't want to even think about that right now. We have to focus on Jack. I swear, I'll kill everyone there. Easy, John. Try to stay calm.
I'm fine.
How the hell did they get to him?
I don't know, but we are getting him back, and they will pay. I promise you that.
What about the gold?
Who gives a damn about the gold? They got Jack.
I hate to break it to you, but I don't think there is any gold. And if there is, it's hidden somewhere no one knows.
What?
I've turned every stone.
For Christ's sake, Hosea. After all that, another perfect scam.
We underestimated them.
No, they underestimated us. Enough talk. There is no point arguing how we got here. This is where we are. And we are going to fix it. So come on! Okay, get your heads right. Nobody makes a move until I... From here.
First Sean, now Jack. We should have stayed out of all of this.
Bit late for that, ain't it?
Come on, let's get this done. John, you sure you're okay?
Like I said, I'm fine.
Follow my lead. Both these redneck families think they can ruin us? I don't think so.
There they are.
Who steals a goddamn boy?
I'm gonna let fly at those sons of bitches!
John, I need you to stay calm. Get down here now, you inbred trash!
Easy, John.
We've come for the boy. You must have known we would.
Shouldn't have messed with our business now, should you?
Whatever complaint you have with us, alleged or otherwise, that is a young boy. That is not the way you do things. Hand him over.
Get the hell off our land.
ain't gonna be civilized about this.
You're gonna die! Get out there! We got this door covered!
Grab the rifle by the chair!
Go around and help John. Did you find another way in? I told you there's no getting in this way. They've got it locked.
But I reckon it might give.
Two, three, go! to kill you too, old woman?
You bastards!
Where's the boy?
We have lived in this house for 120 years. We never had no problems except for
Yankees. Where is the boy? Who took him?
You killed my son!
Oh, and I will surely kill the rest of them unless you start talking.
Oh, I know your time. Common scum.
Where is the boy?
You filth.
All right, we get her out of here.
What about Dan?
Now let's get this hag outside. Any more of her sons to deal with?
No, I reckon they're all dead.
That's right. Burn this dump to the ground. You boys sure Jack ain't in here?
We searched everywhere, Dutch.
You got that one, Arthur?
I guess that's the end of the goddamn cribbage game.
I never liked you.
Why'd you take the boy, Mrs. Braithwaite?
You stole my
boys are off limits.
You stole my horses. Ain't no rules in war, Mr.
Matthews.
Yes, yes, that's it.
Where's the boy?
My sons gave him to Angelo Bronte. So my guess is Saint-Denis. Either there, we're on my boat to Italy.
Let's go.
Arthur, come on.
What are we doing with her?
Leave her.
I told you she was crazy.
It's gonna work out, John. It's gonna work out. Listen to Dutch.
Now, I don't expect you to understand this, but I have never been more proud of you than I am right now, brother. You're doing the right thing.
If I don't get that boy back safe, she'll kill us all.
I know, but looking at this logically, well, that boy is fine. They took him to scare us. Nobody takes a boy to harm him.
He's right, John.
What do you think, Arthur?
The boy will be fine, but, well, of course, Marston's scared rotten. We killed all those people. We stirred up all that trouble for nothing.
No, no, not for nothing. For living. Now, we get that boy back, and we go. Trust me.
Hey, Dutch, we got a problem.
Not a problem. Visitors. A solution. Good day, fine people. Mr. Vanderlind, Mr. Matthews, I presume. And who are you?
Rip Van Winkle.
Huh. Good day, sir. Agent Milton, Pinkerton Detective Agency. Agent Ross. Ah, Mr. Morgan, nice to see you again.
And to what do we owe the pleasure, Agent Moron?
I don't know if you're aware, but this is a civilized land now. We didn't kill all them savages only to allow the likes of you to act like human dignity and basic decency was outmoded or not yet invented. This thing, it's done.
This place ain't no such thing as civilized. It's man, so in love with greed, he has forgotten himself and found only appetites.
And as a consequence, that lets you take what you please, kill whom you please, and hang the rest of us? Who made you the messiah to these lost souls you've led so horribly astray?
I'm nothing but a seeker, Mr. Milton.
You ain't much of anything more than a killer, Mr. Vanderlind. But I came to make a deal. It's time. You come with me, and I give the rest of you 3 days to run off, disappear, and go and live like human beings someplace else.
You came for me? Risk life and limb in this den of lowlifes and murderers so that they might live and love? Ain't that fine?
I don't want to kill all these folk, Dutch. Just you.
In that case, it'd be my honor to join you. Excuse me, friends. I have an appointment to keep with...
I think your new friend should leave now, Dutch.
You're making a big mistake, all of you.
Yeah, dreadful. We have got something. Something to live and die for. How awful for us.
Mr. Milton, stop following us. We'll be gone soon.
I'm afraid I can't. And when I return, I'll be with 50 men. All of you will die. Run away from this place, you fools! Run!
Come on.
Get your damn hands off of me, boy.
What now? We get out of here. And quick. Any ideas?
I know a big old house, hidden in the swamps outside Saint Denis. I'm sure they'll find us eventually, but it should buy us a few days.
A few days is all we need.
There's a spot out by Shady Bell. Lenny and I got into that dispute with the previous occupiers. Place is well hidden.
You and Arthur, ride out to make sure no one else has moved in. Lenny, you go follow those fools out of here. Make sure that they leave. And John, we'll get Jack back, and we'll get going. Rest of you, get packing!
Come on, John.
This is crazy.
We'll get packed up, but we need a new spot offer.
Follow me. I know the way. It's gonna be all right, John.
We should be going for Jack.
We will. But we have to move everyone first before that bastard Milton comes back with an army. We ain't no use to Jack in jail. Or at the end of a rope.
I don't even know what to think no more.
Just gotta keep our cool. Be smart about this.
Smart? Are you joking? We made too much noise once again. We drew them right to us. I mean, how many people we killed the past few weeks?
Far too many.
It's Dutch playing his games. Hosea, too. Getting involved with those two families. Master con men working their magic.
They thought there was a lot of gold.
Yeah, they thought there was money. Ain't there always?
Look, Marston, I don't know what to tell you. Things don't always work out. That ain't nothing new.
Jack's gone. We lost Sean, Mac, Davey, Jenny. And for what?
We can't change what's done. We can only move on.
But one day, we need to start learning from our mistakes.
Come on, it ain't all bad. We've had a rocky run. We'll be okay. We'll get through it.
Dutch will fix it. Dutch will come up with a big plan. Right now, every plan gets us into worse trouble. We're getting further from where we're meant to be going.
All right. Should be just down this path to the left here.
So, what were you talking about before?
Now, you can't put all this on Dutch. You're worked up, and rightly so. Just don't get too far in your head with all this. You'll never get out.
It's a goddamn mess. That poor kid. We chose this life. He didn't. Watch out.
I don't know. I think this life chose us.
You, me, Dutch, Hosea. It's been a long time now.
That's it up ahead.
Four walls and a roof. We're moving up in the world.
You ain't seen inside it yet.
Come on. Sooner we get this done, the better. You sure this place is empty?
I ain't sure on nothing.
All right. Let's leave the horses here and take a look.
Oh, shit! It's them again! Boys, get ready!
Damn it! Still some here.
I can see that. You think there's more of them?
I'll check the house. You keep watch out here.
I think I hear something. You should get in there.
This is ours now!
Holy hell!
Any more of you upstairs? I'm coming for you! You hear me?
Where are you creeps hiding? Come out where I can shoot you!
Tough guy, eh?
I knew you'd come soon enough. You are some of the coward, like you. The bounty hunters, the freedmen, the carpetbaggers, the army of criminals who stole our land and our government. I survived them all. Our fight will live on.
Jesus.
How's it looking up there?
Well, I think that's a lot. Didn't even have to shoot the last one.
Good. Come help me with this, will you? You coming? Here. Give me a hand moving these bodies. Don't want the others walking into this. Follow me. All right, this way. We'll dump the bodies in the swamp over there.
Deal with the rest of the bodies. You go meet up with the caravan, guiding them in. Thank you. got fine living. Ignore the corpses and the alligators. It's paradise.
I love it. Miss Grimshaw, Mr. Pearson, would you two kindly work your magic? Arthur, take a ride with me.
Sure.
Come on.
George?
Yes?
Could I have a word with you?
Not now. Come on, Arthur. Can you believe that, girl? All I've got going on, and she wants to talk.
Everything okay with you two?
I got far more important things to worry about right now than Molly O'Shea.
So, where are we going?
To take a look at this eighth wonder of the civilized world, Saint Denis, I keep hearing about. According to the map, the road up this way should lead us right in there.
All right. I guess this day ain't over yet.
Not quite. Good work back there, Arthur. Everything went okay?
Few loose ends. Nothing major.
And John?
About what you'd expect. He's taking it hard.
We are going to get that boy back, whatever it takes. I need you to start asking around in the city for Bronte. Subtly, of course. Public places, maybe start with the saloons. Anyone who can put us in contact with him.
Of course. What about the Pinkertons?
I'm fairly sure nobody followed us. We moved out fast. We should be safe for a few days here.
And then?
I think we need to move a little further. Put some ocean between us and all of this. The mess with those two families, losing Sean. I see things differently now. For a long time, I truly believed a paradise lay somewhere in the West for us. But I just don't know anymore.
So we're leaving the country now?
Maybe. I'm still thinking about it. Whatever we do, idiot! Okay, there she is. A real city. The future.
Big cities. They're
always repellent.
Exactly.
I'll find you in there. Go see what you can figure out.